A statue will be erected in honor of Sergio Aguero at the Etihad, and rightfully so. Now, a lot of fans were actually quite surprised by the exit. Micah Richards-Gale felt like he deserved at least another year, or at least that Sergio Aguero goes out on his own time, because to our understanding, this seems to be more of Man City's decision. But as his former teammate who spent together for many years, who joined the same summer, Gale, what was your initial reaction to the news?
You know, it's a mixed feeling, really, because if we've seen this year, you know, we can see that he's struggling to be fit. We also know that City is a big machine, you know, and in a way, they are ruthless. You know, they don't really have time to lose. Not saying that it's a waste of time at all, but I'm saying that, you know, they're probably thinking, you know, without, you know, a doubt, he's aging. He hasn't played many games this year, and a team like City needs to be on the front foot. And obviously, you'd like to think that he's still got a few years left in him. Is it enough for Pep and for the club? We don't know. You know, people are saying, people are talking. The only thing I can say is that a fully fit Sergio Aguero still have plenty left in the tank. And obviously, for the fan and for the club, it's I'm not saying it's disturbing, but it's obviously a sad news, because you want him to stay. Also, if you look at the numbers, you'd like to think that he would want to stay a bit longer to kind of get that Wayne Rooney second place, because you know and you feel that he has that in him, you know, to go and get that second or third place. But that's the beauty of football, you know. You get players, they make you live big moments, and then a time come where you have to say thank you very much, and the next player will be perhaps as good and would bring joy to the club. So City are ruthless in that sense, and that's the way it is.
But as ruthless as they can be with a lot of their players, Micah Richards brought up an interesting point that he felt the legendary status that is Sergio Aguero, he should be able to leave on his own terms. Do you not think so, Gale?
Yeah, it is. Again, you know, I'm not there to know the details. I don't know the details. Maybe he's been offered a new contract. Who knows? Maybe he decided not to take it. Maybe he hasn't been offered a new contract. Only him can tell, and the club would be able to say. What we know is that they couldn't agree, and when you cannot agree, then, you know, that's the end of it. So however you want to see it, the way I see it personally, it's a club that is growing every year. The expectations are bigger and bigger every year. And if somehow they don't feel like giving him what he wants, perhaps, then is the end of the story. And that's why I'm using the ruthless word for City, because that's how they are.
But is it the right decision though, Gary? Because like Gale said, he probably still has a lot more in his tank. The fact that a lot of big clubs are now being linked with him shows that he still has a lot of potential to deliver on the big stage. Was this the sensible decision for Man City?
Well, I think a lot of big clubs would be interested in Aguero. Yes, of course. But the danger is that you take a player who's just had a season where he hasn't played too many times, where he's had an awful lot of injuries. If a big club takes him next season and he has a similar record, then that decision would be a bad decision. If Man City keep him and he has a similar record next season to the one he's had this season, again, it would be a bad decision. I agree with Gale Clichy that, you know, if Aguero is fit, he's got goals in him. There's no two ways about him. And it's that big question mark about his fitness. I think officially the club and the player have said it's by mutual agreement that they're parting the ways. And I think that's how it should be, because they've both been absolutely fantastic for each other. You know, football is, and Gal used the word, brutal. You know, when you are no longer of any use in the club's eyes, you're out. But likewise, a player, when he feels that it is time to go, he will force a move. Not that that is the case in this situation. You know, it's tough, tough, multi-million pound business.
And, you know, whenever we have the whole discussion of the Premier League's best ever strikers, his name is almost always in the top five or top 10 list, but almost never makes it to number one. It is usually either Alan Shearer or Thierry Henry. But when you look at his goals and you look at his goals, minutes to goals ratio, is he perhaps the most underrated striker in the Premier League, Gary?
Well, I think the stats say that goals per minute, you know, he's the very best. Shearer is the all-time top goal scorer. Then you've got Wayne Rooney. Then you've got Andy Cole. You know, Aguero is right up there amongst them. Yes, Thierry Henry, you know, fantastic goal scorer. And probably as far as style and, you know, panache, then I would put Henry right very much towards number one. It's subjective. If it's purely numbers, well, Aguero isn't number one, two or three. But during his career at Manchester City, when he joined from Atletico Madrid, if anybody had said, well, in 10 years' time, these will be his figures, I think Manchester City would have been delighted. And of course, they still are delighted.
What do you think, Gil? I mean, if you were to look at the numbers, like I mentioned, if you were to judge a striker based on how often and how consistent he produced goals, it is that minutes to goals ratio, and Sergio Aguero takes it tops. He's almost never make it to number one in people's best strikers list. And also, are you surprised that he's never, ever been the PFA Player of the Year either?
Yeah, that's I can see where you're coming from. And in a way, if you look at the numbers, if you look at the stats, there's no doubt that he's up there and he's the best. But, you know, I think football has changed a little bit since I was playing, you know, for Arsenal. And you know, when you look at that team at the time with Thierry, I can only speak for him because I had the chance to play with both of them. Thierry was the player that was going to get you the goal that you needed. Sergio is also has that, you know, but he has a group of players around him that chop in, you know, people like Sterling, people like De Bruyne, people like Mahrez, they're all chipping in and you know, the figures are double figures for all of them, more or less. Thierry was the main man. And of course, that's a debate that, you know, you can speak and you can start today and finish in a week time. But I think in the end, it's subjective to who you like and who you have love for. And of course, you know, Shearer is up there with the numbers. Wayne Rooney is up there. I think it's not a question about who is the best, but I think you have to put a package of four or five players, and definitely he's up there, yes.
But would you still rate him underrated, though, in the bigger picture sense and with everything that you've just said?
Well, if you look at the individual awards that he never got, obviously he's massively underrated. And I played with him, and I know how hard it is. You've seen that goal, I think, in the little video you did. His goal against United, I remember, I think he was on the bench, and I could see him on the side of the pitch, you know, not doing anything as a warm-up, you know. And then he comes in, got this first ball, dribbled past four or five players and smashes it, you know. And that was Kun, you know. That's Kun, and he's, again, I love this word, but he's a ruthless striker, you know. He's got everything. He's got power, he's got speed, he's got quick feet. He's up there for sure. Is he underrated? Again, it comes to how you like the player. Who do you like better? Who do you like best? And for me, yeah, top three is in my top three, yes. But very-